of the type 1 upon sin x to the power m cos x to the power n, where m plus n in this case is equal to 1 by 2 plus 3 by 2 is equal to 2, which is an even number. Therefore, it should be divided either by cos square x or by sin square x. So on dividing it by cos square x, definitely both numerator and denominator must be divided by cos square x. Let this integral be I. So this is sin x to the power 1 by 2, cos x to the power 3 by 2 upon cos square x dx, which we can write 1 by cos square x as sec square x upon sin x to the power 1 by 2. And denominator is having cos square x, and if we shift this cos x to the power 3 by 2 in denominator, it can be written like cos x whole to the power 2 minus 3 by 2 dx. So this will be integral sec square x upon sin x to the power 1 by 2 whole upon cos x to the power 2 minus 3 by 2 is cos 1 by 2, cos x to the power 1 by 2, which will become tan x to the power 1 by 2. So this is sec square x upon tan x to the power 1 by 2, which we can write as root 10 x, or simply let it be tan x to the power 1 by 2. 10x to the power 1 by 2 dx. Now, as numerator is derivative of 10x, we shall put t is equal to 10x, and therefore dt by dx will be sec square x implies dt is equal to sec square x dx, means sec square x dx of numerator can be replaced by dt. Therefore, I is equal to dt upon t to the power 1 by 2, which we can write t to the power minus 1 by 2 dt, and integration of t to the power minus 1 by 2 will be t to the power minus 1 by 2 plus 1 upon minus 1 by 2 plus 1 plus an integral constant C. On simplifying it, we find t to the power 1 by 2 upon 1 by 2 plus C is equal to 2 times root t plus C, because t to the power 1 by 2 is same as root t. And at the last, we shall put value of t, which is 10x. So it becomes 2 root 10x plus C. And the most surprising thing about this integral, this is a very popular integral, which is most of the times asked in this form, root 10x upon sin x cos x dx. So many a times this question is asked in this form, root 10x upon sin x cos x. Let us see how is it possible. So on simplifying it, means numerator we can write as root sin x upon root cos x, and denominator is sin x, which we can write as root sin x whole square, and this cos x, let it be cos x, which we can write as root sin x will cancel this square. So we have 1 upon root sin x into cos x into root cos x dx. So root sin x is sin x whole to the power 1 by 2 एंड दिस कॉस एक्स रूट कॉस एक्स इज कॉस एक्स होल टू द पावर 3/2. तो दिस काइंड ऑफ इंटीग्रल इज रूट टेन एक्स अपॉन साइन एक्स कॉस एक्स, एंड इन दिस वे इट कैन बी इंटीग्रेटेड.